弟兄姊妹们平安，下午好。让我们开始今天的敬拜。诗篇九十六篇一到四节。
弟兄姊妹下午好，我哋开始今日嘅敬拜。诗篇九十六章一至四。
你们要向耶和华唱新歌。
你们要向耶和华唱新歌，
全地都要向耶和华歌唱，
全地都要向耶和华歌唱，
要向耶和华歌唱，称颂他的名，
要向耶和华歌唱，称颂他的名，
天天传扬他的救恩，
天天传扬他的救恩，
在列邦中述说他的荣耀，
在列邦中传述说他的荣耀。
在万民中述说他的奇事，
在万民中述说他的奇事，
因耶和华为大，当受极大的赞美。
因耶和华为大，当受极大的赞美。
他在万神之上，当受敬畏。
他在万神之上，当受敬畏。
好，下面是颂赞生命圣诗圣哉三一。
我哋嚟颂赞生命圣书，圣哉三一。
真男姊妹系忙于煮饭啊，系我哋煮饭，我哋而家系第一二首暂时由我嚟代替，请一林。我哋唱《生命圣诗》第五首。
Thank you.
同心祷告。
让我们同心祷告。
天父，我们这群不配的罪人。
天父，我们这群不配的罪人。
来到你的殿中诚心祷告。
来到你的殿中诚心祷告。
我们所有从血气而来的委屈、沮丧、不甘、愤怒。
我们所有从血气而来的委屈、沮丧、不甘、愤怒，
在你的公义和怜悯面前显得那么可笑和不值一提。
在你的公义和怜悯面前显得那么可笑和不值一提。
我们所有的生命中的荣耀都在你的震怒之下。
我们所有生命中的荣耀都在你的震怒之下。
我们所有惊夸的岁月好像一声叹息。
我们所有惊夸的岁月好像一声叹息。
我们那千疮百孔的身躯和破碎的灵魂如何能够在你面前站立得住呢？
我们那千疮百孔的身躯和破碎的灵魂如何能够在你面前站立得住呢？
唯有单单靠着那十字架上的宝血带来的无尽恩典，才使我们有勇气来到你的施恩座前。
唯有单单靠着那十字架上宝血带来无尽恩典，才使我们有勇气来到你的施恩座前。
承认自己的过犯，
承认自己的过犯，
保得你丰盛的怜悯和慈爱，
保得你丰盛的怜悯和慈爱，
叫我们一生一世欢呼喜乐，
叫我们一生一世欢呼喜乐。
主啊，你曾借着先知的口警告我们。
主啊，你曾借着先知的口警告我们。
一人若转离异行而作罪孽，
一人若转离异行而作罪孽，
照着恶人所行一切可憎的事而行，
就照恶人所行一切可憎的事而行，
他岂能存活吗？
他岂能存活吗？
他所行的一切义都不被纪念，
他所行的一切义都不被纪念。
他必因所行的罪所犯的恶死亡，
他必因所行的罪所犯的恶来死亡。
而恶人若回头离开所行的恶，
若恶人若回头离开所行的恶，
行正直与合理的事，
行正直与合理的事，
他必将性命救活了。
他必将性命救活了，
因为他思量，
因为他思量，
回头离开所犯的一切罪过，
回头离开所犯的一切罪过，
必定存活不致死亡，
必定存活不致死亡。
你以无尽的恩慈对我们说，
你以无尽的恩慈对我们说，
你们的罪虽像朱红，必变成雪白。
你们的罪虽像朱红，必变成雪白。
虽红如丹颜，必白如羊毛。
虽如同丹颜，必白如羊毛。
主啊，我们借着从你而来的信心，得蒙赦罪。
主啊，我们借着从你而来的信心，得蒙赦罪。
借着你的爱，
借着你的爱，
我们献上感恩和赞美。
我们献上感恩和赞美。
见证主丰盛的恩慈。
见证主丰盛的恩慈。
主啊，我们为教会的全体会众祷告。
主啊，我们为教会的全体会众祷告。
求你赐给每个人以纯全正直的心思。
求你赐给每个人以纯正正直的心思。
没有矫饰和虚伪来到神面前。
没有矫饰和虚伪来到神面前。
把自己的心思意念真诚地献给神。
把自己的心思意念真诚地献给神。
追求圣洁和公义。
追求圣洁和公义，
与你赐给我们的恩相称，
与你赐给我们的恩相称。
也求你纪念许多弟兄姊妹进食祷告，
也求你纪念许多弟兄姊妹进食祷告，
认罪悔改的心，
认罪悔改的心，
来保守教会的合一，
来保守教会的合一。
主啊，我们为明天的阵亡将士纪念日祷告。
主啊，我们为明天的阵亡将士纪念日祷告。
求你纪念那些为了这片土地的自由和和平献出生命的灵魂。
求你纪念那些为了这片土地的自由与和平献上生命的灵魂。
借着他们的牺牲， 来保守这个伟大的国家免受各样罪恶的侵害。
藉着他们的牺牲来保守这个伟大的国家免受各样罪恶的侵害。
也请为那些受伤家庭的亲人朋友们祷告。
也请为那些受伤家庭的亲人朋友们祷告。
从牺牲的英雄们汲取力量。
从牺牲的英雄们吸取力量。
继承他们的遗志。
继承他们的遗志。
以更大的爱心去服务和侍奉这个国家。
以更大的爱心去服务和侍奉这个国家。
使之成为上帝儿女的乐土。
使之成为上帝儿女的乐土。
荣耀他的尊名。
荣耀他的尊名。
主啊，我们为即将到来的中西部夏令会和2025年的筹备工作祷告。
主啊，我们为即将来到的中西部夏令会和2025年的筹备工作祷告。
希望在这每年一次的属灵盛宴中，
希望在每年一次的属灵盛宴中，
弟兄姊妹们的生命能得到滋养和浇灌。
弟兄姊妹们的生命能得到滋养和浇灌。
借着圣灵的光照和洁净，
借着圣灵的光照和洁净，
帮助我们为与世界分别为圣，
帮助我们与世界分别为圣，
并得着知识和属灵上的装备，
并得着知识和属灵上的装备，
能忠实地进入下一期的筹备工作，
能忠实地进入下一期的筹备工作，
分享心中火热的盼望和使人平安的福音。给更多需要的人，
分享心中火热的盼望和使人平安的福音，给更多需要的人。
我们以主导文来结束我们的祷告。
我们以主导文来结束我们的祷告。
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿们。好，下面是起义，神的威权。
下面是起义，神的威权。
耶和华作王，他以威严为衣穿上。
耶和华作王，他以威严为衣穿上。
耶和华以能力为衣。
耶和华以能力为衣。
以能力束腰。
以能力束腰。
世界就坚定。
世界就坚定。
不得动摇。
不得动摇。
你的宝座从来坐立地。
耶和华在高处大有能力。
耶和华在高处大有能力。
胜过诸水的响声。
胜过诸水的响声。
洋海的大浪。
洋海的大浪。
耶和华，你的法度最正确，你的律令千万万岁，是有神的。
地和其中所充满的，
地和其中所充满的，
世界和住在其间的，
世界和住在其间的，
都属耶和华，
都属耶和华。
他把我地建立在海上，安定在大地上。
谁能登耶和华的山？
谁能登耶和华的山？
谁能站在他的圣所？
谁能站在他的圣所？
就是走遍众星，不上去往，世世不还的赞美人。
耶和华作王，
耶和华作王，
愿地快乐，
愿地快乐，
愿众海岛欢喜，
愿众海岛欢喜。
物患无忧患在他的四围，公义和公平是他辅助的根基。
有烈火在他前头行，
有烈火在他前头行，
烧灭他四围的敌人，
消灭他四围的敌人。
他的闪电光照世界，
他的闪电光照世界。
大地看见便震动，
大地看见便震动。
居家上清洁我的病例都是一群的一起的病例运修法律啦。
诸天表明他的公义，
诸天表明他的公义，
万民看见他的荣耀，
万民看见他的荣耀。
耶和华是主神，愿我的神石被人称颂，愿救我的神被人称颂。
下面是会众唱诗《宝血活泉》。
下边是会众唱诗《宝血活泉》。
下我们一起来读经。今天要读的经文是以赛亚书59:1-2。
下边系我哋一齐嚟读经，今日嘅经文系以赛亚书59:1-2。
59:1。耶和华的膀臂并非缩短，不能拯救；耳朵并非发沉，不能听见。但你们的罪孽使你们与神隔绝，你们的罪恶使他掩面不听你们。好，下面请郝牧师带来今天的主论信息：分离的悲剧。
下面请教牧师预备我们今日的信息：分离的悲剧。
Good afternoon.
下午好。
This afternoon, and I'll probably keep saying morning.
今日下午，可能再讲系早晨。
We look into God's word to learn about the tragedy of being separated from God.
今日我哋嚟睇神嘅话语系与神分离嘅悲剧。
In fact, all of the world is separated from God.
喺世界上都会同神嘅分离系一个悲剧。
Men and women everywhere, when we are born separated from God.
世界上嗰啲男女出生嘅时候就与神分离，带来嘅悲剧。
Because we are sinners.
因为我哋系罪人。
And we consider that this morning, this afternoon.
今日日下昼，让我哋一齐嚟思考下。
But I want us to think particularly about the tragedy of God's people being separated from God.
特别系讲到神嘅子民嘅时候，与神分离嘅嗰种嘅悲剧。
I hope that we feel something of the weight of the sorrow that God's church can be separated from Him.
我哋要嚟到思考下神嘅教会因为罪带来嘅分离。
But what we learn here in these two verses from Israel is that the sins of the church separate God from His people.
我哋今日嚟思考下，就系以色列佢哋嘅子民系分离之后带来嘅悲剧。
By the sins of the church, I don't mean the institutional church.
我讲话教会嘅罪唔系话传统嘅教会。
The church is a body of Christians.
教会嘅整体团结就系基督徒。
And if it's the sins of the Christians in the church that can separate us from God.
教会嘅基督徒如果系有罪咧，就同神嘅分离。
If we are willful and unrepentant in our sin,
如果我哋系愿意嚟到悔改悔改嘅话，
then that removes the presence of God from us.
佢就会将神佢就会同我哋分隔。
The whole book of Isaiah has already dealt to some degree with this issue.
上本嘅以赛亚书佢就讲出呢一个情况。
God warned Israel that they had to repent and return to Him.
神希望以色列人回转回到佢嗰度。
And they did not.
但系佢哋冇。
And so God brought judgment, and they went into Assyria in exile.
所以佢系好严肃咁样同以色列人讲。
Later, Isaiah warned Judah to repent.
再跟住落嚟咧，以赛亚就希望犹大嚟到回转。
And they would not repent.
但系佢哋都冇回转。
So God sent them into Babylon in exile.
所以佢哋送到去巴比伦。
In these last chapters of Isaiah, God is preparing His people for the coming salvation.
喺呢一嘅经文里边，最后咧，神系预备咗一个地方，佢哋回转之后去嘅。
And He begins to show them the promises of the salvation that God would bring.
讲出神对佢哋嘅应许。
And so that they might turn and trust in Him. So when we come to our passage this morning in verse 1,
今天我们的信息是在经文第一,
we find that God's people are upset with him. That part really starts earlier in chapter
58.
In chapter 58, they see the judgment coming from Babylon. And they decide they need to do more religious things so that God will hear their prayers. So they go to the temple more often. And they pray. And they fast. And they're doing these things, but God is not answering. And so they blamed God. Essentially, in that chapter, they say, doesn't God see all that we're doing? We seek him every day. We go to the temple. We ask for righteous judgments against Babylon. We delight to come to him. We're even fasting. We're sacrificing our bodies so that God will hear our prayers. But God hasn't done anything that we
asked.
So they concluded that there was something wrong with God. That God couldn't see them. Or God couldn't hear them. Or that his hand was too short to save them. It's kind of like a picture of a little boy at a dinner table. And his parents give him Brussels sprouts to eat. And the boy looks at the Brussels sprouts and he doesn't want to eat them. He decides that he needs ice cream instead. So his parents have shown them their will for him. It is to eat the Brussels sprouts. But he says, no, I want ice cream. And so he begins to ask and to plead. But even though he's saying all of these things, the sprouts are still there and there's no ice cream. So he takes more action. He goes on a fast. He says, I won't eat until I have ice cream. And that doesn't work either. So he decides he must humble himself. And he lies down on the floor, face down at their feet. And he begins to slap the floor. I want ice cream. And the parents are just going on calmly eating their dinner. And he keeps trying all these things. Every once in a while they look down and they see him and then they just put a few more Brussels sprouts on his plate. And so he finally decides, okay, I have to pull my last card. And he begins to tell them, this is all your fault. You don't love me. You hate me. You want me to go hungry. That's exactly the picture we have of Israel as we come to this passage. That's a picture of the disobedience of God's people. Even the picture of a disobedient church. That's what vain religion looks like. When people use religion to try to get what they want from God.
当人用佢自己嘅宗教想取悦佢自己想要嘅嘢。
When all of our seeking and all of the things we do are so that we can get what we want from God.
佢以为用佢宗教嘅方法去要求得到嘅嘢。
But the point is, they don't want God Himself.
但系重点就系佢唔想神喺度帮助佢。
And so God told them what was wrong with their fasting.
所以神就讲俾佢听，你哋咁样禁食系嘅原因系冇用嘅。
Outwardly, they were staying away from food.
佢哋咧就离开食物。
But at the same time, inwardly, they were filling themselves with the lusts and pleasures of the world.
但喺内心里边咧，佢觉得同世界有嚟自好大嘅压力。
And so God wasn't listening.
所以神冇聽到佢講。
When we come to our verse, verse 1,
讓我哋嚟睇到我哋自己。
The prophet answers.
呢度係先知嘅英文。
He says, Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, or his ear dull that it cannot hear.
以上話又話個膀臂並係縮短，唔係診不能拯救，耳朵並非係聽唔到你哋講。
So Isaiah tells them plainly that you have it all wrong.
以賽亞話俾佢聽，你哋咁樣做係錯誤嘅。
That God is not the problem here.
唔係神嘅問題。
That God's righteous right hand is still able to save.
神嘅右手，佢嘅公義仍然可以喺度拯救。
His hand is not too short.
佢嘅膀臂唔係縮短嘅。
So when conflict comes into any relationship.
所以當一個衝突嚟到任何一種關係
，or when conflict even comes into a church，
呢啲衝突甚至嚟到我哋教會
，God can take care of it。
神係可以處理好嘅。
God is not the problem。
神唔係一個問題。
But He will not take it away until His people are trusting Him。
佢唔會攞咗呢啲問題解決處理好，直至人係回轉到佢嗰度。
So Israel was praying and praying.
所以以色列人咧一面祈禱祈禱。
But at the same time, they were going against God's will to find their own plan to save themselves.
第一次又一次，佢哋係唔回到神嘅面前，去做佢自己行佢自己嘅路。
So God stopped listening.
所以神就唔聽佢哋講啦。
God has a gift that He can turn a deaf ear to empty prayers.
神係有權令佢令到。
And He knows when our prayers are empty and self-centered.
So, 佢知道有啲人聽唔到佢講，因為佢哋自我為中心啦。
And He knows when they're genuine and humble.
佢哋一定要嚟好順服神。
So the first thing we need to learn here is that when God's people are in turmoil, God is not the source of the problem.
所以我哋知道一切世界問題咧，唔係神嘅問題。
If there's a problem in a family.
是家人裏面的問題。
God's not the problem.
神不是有問題。
If there's a problem in a church,
如果是教會有問題。
God is not the problem.
都不是神的問題。
And we may feel that there's a problem and we have to find the solution and we have to work towards it in our way.
當我們找到有問題的時候，我們認為，我們自己用想的方法來解決這個情況。
But the only way to solve spiritual problems is to bring them and trust them to God.
其實一個喺屬靈上邊嘅緊，就最緊要係順服神。
So we need to learn what Israel failed to learn.
所以我哋要學習以色列人學到嘅嘢，點樣學人，我哋亦要咁樣學。
And what too many churches fail to learn.
有好多教會佢亦都有需要咁學。
That when there is trouble,
當嗰度有困難
，the problem never lies with God.
問題從來都唔係來自神。
So secondly, in verse 2, we are introduced by a little word that shows a great contrast.
經文第二節嘅講到我哋呢度咧有少少嘅問題啦。
And at least in the English, verse 2 starts with the word but.
喺英文嚟講咧，就有一個係但係。
So Isaiah says, God is not the problem.But you are.
以賽亞講咗，神唔係個問題，係你哋。
He says your iniquities have separated you from God.
你哋嘅
It's your sins that have hidden the face of God from you. He pictures their sin as building a great wall between them and God. The wall goes up just like any other wall. Outside you lay brick upon brick upon brick, and the wall goes up. But this wall grows as sin is laid upon sin upon sin. And God has been patient with Israel. But they continued in their sin until there's this wall of separation. In the following verses, Isaiah begins to tell them about their sins. He lists them. And we won't read all of them, but there are sins like anger and lying and deceit. Sins like false testimony and empty excuses. They lay snares for people. They're eager to carry out their own plans. And they walk in crooked paths. This is a picture of God's people when they let their own passions and desires rule them. In verses 9 to 15, they're repeated in similar fashion. Except there is the people confessing the sins that they've committed against God. Seems they understand that they have built these sins up themselves. And in the end, there's a wall of separation between church and God. And God chooses not to see. And God chooses not to hear. And he chooses to let them taste the bitterness of their own sins. There's no greater tragedy than that. They are God's own people. He chose them. He loves them. He purchased them. And now they are separated from their God. Separated by a large wall of sins that they made for themselves. It's really a tragic picture. In Genesis 3, we find the story of Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve had been given all things. God gave them paradise. God gave them a perfect marriage. God even gave them himself. But in Genesis 3, they gave all of that up. They decided they wanted the one thing that God hadn't given them. So they disobeyed God. In verse 8 of Genesis 3 says, "And they heard the sound of the Lord God," this is after they sinned, And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord among the trees of the garden.
創世記第三章第八節講到，佢哋聽到神嘅聲音喺伊甸園裏邊，所以佢哋咧就係知道自己所犯嘅罪，就躲藏起嚟啦。
They had been given everything.
佢已經得到，樣樣都得到啦。
And they gave it up because they thought they could rule the world themselves without God.
佢哋放棄咗，佢哋以為自己可以去計劃安排佢哋自己嘅路。
And then that evening, God comes into the garden to walk with them in fellowship.
所以嗰晚神去到伊甸園裏邊。
He would come in the evening to enjoy them and to love them.
佢以前可以好。與神喺埋一齊好喜樂嘅，可以喺埋一齊可以享受嗰種樂園嘅快樂。
And this time God comes.
但係今次神嚟啦。
And they hide from God.
佢哋對躲藏起嚟。
There's really no sadder verse in Scripture.
冇另外一個嘅咁痛苦嘅字嚟到形容啦。
Their sin has separated them from the God that they used to love and fellowship with.
以前咧，神非常之愛佢哋嘅喺個樂園裏邊，但係而家因為嘅罪，所以與神隔絕。
So this is the tragedy of separation.
呢個就係因為悲劇帶來嘅分離。
If you know Christ, we should be able to see this picture well.
如果你係認識神，你就睇到呢幅圖畫係好清楚嘅。
Because in so many ways we are like Adam and Eve.
好多時候我哋好似亞當夏娃。
God has given us all things in Christ.
神俾咗我哋全部嘅嘢啦。
God has given you everything you need for life and godliness.
神俾咗我哋喺生命上邊你所需要嘅一切都俾咗你。
God has given you Himself.
甚至俾佢自己。
His Son.
佢嘅兒子。
And His Spirit.
同埋嘅聖靈。
And God invites you to be in the garden with Him.
神邀請你嚟到嘅園裏邊，同佢喺埋一齊。
I wonder this afternoon is that where you are？
我喺今呢個下晝裏邊，我喺度諗你係點樣嘅咧
？Are you living in the garden with God？
你係咪喺個伊甸園裏邊同神喺埋一齊
？You all probably remember the hymn。
你或者記得有一首詩歌。
I come to the garden alone。
我單獨嚟到個花園裏邊。
While the dew is still on the roses,
或者嗰度有啲玫瑰花。
And the voice I hear falling on my ear,
我聽到嘅聲音喺我耳仔度就講。
The Son of God discloses,
神嘅兒子係與我一齊。
And He walks with me,
佢同我一齊同行。
And He talks with me,
同我一齊傾偈。
And He tells me I am His own,
佢講俾我聽，我係屬於佢自己嘅。
And the love we share.
我哋分享嘅愛
，as we tarry there，
我哋就喺嗰度一齊。
None other has ever known。
其他人係唔明白。
That's the love and the fellowship that God's people are to have with God。
嗰種嘅愛，嗰種嘅同伴係神俾我哋嘅。
I wonder when is the last time that you were alone in the garden with God？
我喺度諗你最後嗰次同神喺埋嘅。
Did you hear the voice of Jesus telling you about the glories of His Father?
你有冇聽到神嘅聲音對你話你係屬於天父㗎？
Did He speak to you about the Father's delight and love for you?
佢聽到天父對我哋嘅愛同埋對我哋嘅我哋對佢嘅依靠咧。
As you listened to Him and you talked with Him, was your heart filled with hope and with joy?
你嘅心有冇充滿對佢嘅盼望、喜樂？喺埋一齊咯。
Did it cause you to want to live, to be close to God？
係令到你能夠與神嚟到接近。
Did you find a longing to fight against sin so that you could be closer with God？
有冇揾到你點樣同罪嚟嘅搏鬥？你為著就係要接近神、親近神。
For so many Christians。Those kinds of days are few and far between.
So, 好多基督徒就係離開。
We ought to ask, How can that be? This is to be the normal Christian life. God gave us His life. His life is in our soul. So that we can commune with Him and enjoy Him. Christ is in us. How can it be that we would be separated from God? The answer of Isaiah is that our iniquities have made a separation between us and our God. When Adam and Eve were cast out of the Garden of Eden, I can only imagine the terror that they felt when God drove them out of the garden. The scripture says God drove them out. What they must have thought when they looked back and saw that the gate was closed and the angels were there with the flaming swords so that they could never go back in. Now they were out in the darkness, separated from God. How afraid they must have been. And yet with time they became accustomed to living in the wild. For in a very real sense, they too had become wild. And they got used to being away from God. When we begin to tolerate sin in our hearts, of course we begin with the ones that seem like little sins to us. But when we begin to tolerate sin in our hearts, we begin to build a wall. And it doesn't seem so bad at first. But it gets bigger and stronger. And we begin to get used to it. And we begin to tell ourselves that it's really not that bad. We tell ourselves that the Christians who talk about being in the garden, that that's just sentimental talk. We tell ourselves that they just have a kind of dependence on religion. And we tell ourselves that those kind of Christians are really no different from us. And we try to very hard to believe what we tell ourselves. And when that happens, as the wall grows, it hardens. So that eventually we don't even realize what a tragedy it all is. But we must see that it's a tragedy for God's people to be separated from God. That it's, in fact, the greatest tragedy possible for a Christian to bear. For God's people or God's church to be separate and walking in our own ways. It's the most tragic thing that can happen to a church. And yet, That is just the place where so many Christians and so many churches find themselves. Away from God. Apart from His presence. And hidden from His face. Just like Israel and Judah. And all because they themselves have built a wall of sin that separates them from
God.
So this morning, or this afternoon, I want to ask, where are you? Are you enjoying life in the garden with God? Have you slipped away so that you're just outside, perhaps? Or is it possible that you're far away? If you're not in the garden with God, then the first thing, the one thing you must do, is begin to ask God to bring you back into the garden. To ask God to do something about the wall. And seek Him in prayer. And seek Him in His Word. For God is merciful and gracious. But the question should come to our mind. How can the wall of sin come down? And the answer is by the long arm of God's grace. A little bit later in chapter 59 and verse 15, the scripture says this. The Lord saw it. Excuse me. The Lord saw it and it displeased Him that there was no justice. He saw that there was no man and wondered that there was no one to intercede. Then His own arm brought Him salvation, and His righteousness upheld Him.
15-16.
So God's people didn't see the wall. But God saw it. And God knew that they could do nothing. That He must do something to remove the wall. Of course, God knew from the very beginning there was nothing that they could do. Men and women everywhere will try all kinds of different religions to try to get the wall down. But they always fail. Even Christians, we may decide, oh, we need to do something. And so they start searching from their own ideas and from their own wisdom. And think if we just take this action or that action, then everything will be okay. And they lament that all of their own efforts keep failing. But they don't learn that there's nothing we can do. Sinners can't dismantle sin.
And
if we try the best of our own plans and and ways. We only make the wall higher and stronger. But we're told the Lord saw it. Only His mighty arm could tear down the wall.
So
he turned to his son. And he said, "Son, go tear down that wall." So a redeemer came to Zion. And Jesus dressed himself in human flesh. And he came to us as one of us. And by his righteous life and by his atoning death, Jesus tore down the wall. So that, as Paul says later, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off, have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For He Himself is our peace. He has made us both one. And He has broken down in His flesh the dividing wall of hostility. The wall of sin that separates us from God. That separates even His own people from Him. Can only be broken down by Jesus. The wall of sin that separates a disobedient church from God. Can only be broken down by Jesus. But we give thanks and praise to God because Jesus did tear down the wall. Jesus made the way for His people to enjoy His fellowship, even if we've turned away. But we find at the end of the chapter that there are two kinds of people. Among God's people, there were those who never turned back to God. And their wall never came down. Outwardly, they claimed to be a part of the people of God. But they never experienced His grace and mercy. But we're also told that there's another people. These are those who find mercy and grace. And the wall of sin that had separated them from God came down. And they feared the Lord their God. And they loved Him. And they loved His glory. And we're told that this people will fill all the earth. So what made the difference between those who never turned back and those for whom the wall came down? The wall comes down for everyone who turns to Jesus in faith and repentance. If we will lay down our sins and own up to what we and our sins have done, and if we will turn to God and ask Him for forgiveness and mercy,
and if
we turn away from our sinful ways, for these, the wall always comes down.
咁樣嗰方向就會。
If we will approach Jesus like that,
如果我哋將耶穌基督咁樣樣嚟睇
，He promises anyone who comes to me,
佢答應我哋任何人嚟到我嘅面前
，I will never cast away.
我唔會將佢排除出去。
So we wonder.
我哋好喺度諗啦。
Then why doesn't everyone come to Christ?
因為有個個人都嚟到神面前咯。
Why do those walls come back anyway?
點解嗰棟牆要翻轉頭咧？
And it's because so many people will never submit to the righteousness of God.
就嗰啲人咧，佢哋冇將委託自己嘅罪完完全全順服嚟到神嘅面前。
They're not willing to admit that there's nothing that they can do to bring themselves to God.
佢哋冇承認自己係無能為力嘅，佢會唔可以將呢棟牆去拆毀嘅。
They will not repent of their sin.
佢哋冇將佢嘅罪嚟到回轉。
They're unwilling to turn from the life that they want.
佢哋唔願意將佢哋嘅生命佢哋嘅光就用喺佢生命上邊。
So that they never receive the life that God offered.
所以佢永遠得唔到神要俾佢哋嘅新嘅生命。
You see, Judah wanted all the benefits.
所以猶大人佢想，猶大咧佢想所有嘅利益。
But they wanted it their own way.
但係佢哋用佢自己嘅方法。
And a person can want all the benefits of Jesus' cross.
人所想要嘅所有嘅利益咧，就係。耶穌基督喺十字架上
，but refused to bear their own cross。
但係佢拒絕孭佢自己嘅十字架。
True repentance is a cross。
真嘅回轉就係十字架。
It's a death sentence。
亦都係一種嘅債。
We choose by faith to die daily to what me the sinner wants。
我哋係藉著嘅信心嚟到神嘅面前。
And to submit to what God the righteous wants.
承認神嘅公義。
And there are too many that refuse to submit to God.
好多人咧就係拒絕嚟到接受神。
And yet we understand the price that was paid for us.
同埋我哋有承認，知道耶穌基督已經付上呢一個嘅代價。
We were purchased by the precious blood of Christ.
我哋嘅目標就係要得到耶穌基督嗰個公義。
And set apart to be His holy people.
即係分將我哋嘅分離咧，就係因為係一啲我哋嘅聖潔嘅人。
And the longing to be back in His presence.
我哋渴望翻去神嗰度。
Should humble us so that we're ready to repent of our sin.
谦卑我哋自己嚟到神嘅面前，承认我哋自己嘅罪。
We'll trust God to deal with everyone else.
我哋相信神会对我哋任何一个人可以做嘅。
But as for me, I will trust the Lord.
对我嚟讲，我系信靠信服神。
So then, when Christians are divided,
所以当基督徒分别嘅时候。
And when sin separates us from the presence of God,
就係因為罪將我哋與神隔絕。
And or when our sins separate us from one another,
當我哋嘅罪與神隔絕嘅時候，真係乜都答唔到啦。
Then there's really only one thing that we can do.
只有一件事我哋可以做。
That's each of us and all of us to get on our knees before God.
就每一個人，所有嘅人。就係跪低喺咗神嘅面前
，and to lay our heart before Him，
將我哋嘅心擺喺神面前
，and to say, God, search my heart and see if there's any wicked way in me。
神啊，睇我內心有冇罪念能夠幫助我
？Say, Lord, am I holding on to my own sin？
神咧就會將我嘅心照耀出嚟，睇到我自己裏邊嘅罪念。
And then to ask Him for grace,
就尋求佢嘅恩典
to repent of the sin that He shows us.
当佢讲俾我听我哋嘅罪嘅时候，我哋就要回转啦。
So if each of us does that,
如果每一个人都咁做
，then those walls between us and God are coming down.
嗰缝墙与神隔绝咧，佢就会 被打低。
Then we will be drawing nearer and nearer to God.
咁我哋就会同神越嚟越亲近，亲近。
And if we're all drawing nearer to God,
所以我哋所有人与神嚟到亲近。
Then necessarily we will be drawing closer to one another.
咁我哋彼此之间都会彼此能够互相接近。
And so in these days we've been asking the church to pray.
所以喺今日嚟讲，我哋希望教会为我哋大家都一齐嚟到祷告。
And to set aside a day, or two to fast and pray.
所以我哋喺教会里边建立一个禁食嘅祈祷。
Not so that God will work in someone else.
让神能够喺我哋在座之中能够建立一啲嘅佢嘅作为嚟。
But so that God will work in each of us.
让神能够对我哋每一个人都有能够起到一个个好好嘅作用。
And if we will pray for God's desire to be our desire.
我哋祈祷用我哋遵照神嘅旨意，唔系我哋自己本人嘅旨意。
We're praying for our own repentance and obedience.
我哋祈求将我哋嘅顺服佢，同埋将我哋自己仰望佢。
Then we will begin to see a transformation.
咁我哋就睇到呢个嘅转捩点。
And relationships will begin to change and heal and grow.
咁我呢个关系咧，我哋就会喺我哋生命上边有成长。
And there will be humility and confession of sin to one another.
咁我哋承认自己嘅，彼此承认自己嘅罪。
And there will be forgiveness and reconciliation.
彼此承认嘅时候，我哋可以轻易清醒。
And there will be peace and joy.
我哋就会有平安喜乐。
That's what God promises.
呢个系神嘅应允。
If we turn to Him,
如果我哋回转去神嗰度
，and call on our Redeemer,
呢个系俾我哋叫做个拯救。
Then Jesus, just as He can heal one of us,
耶稣基督佢会医治我哋每个人。
He can heal us together.
佢可以医治我哋一个人，亦都医治到我哋全部嘅人。
That's His desire for us.
所以我哋。是有这样的渴望。
That's His will for us.
这是我们的愿望。
If we will turn to Him.
让我们回转在祂的。
In repentance.
悔改。
And in faith.
有信心。
Let's pray.
让我们一起祈祷。
Our Father in Heaven, we thank You this afternoon.
天上的父啊，我们感谢你给我们这段下午的这个时刻。
We thank You that You were not content to have us behind a wall of sin.
感謝你不會再繼續讓我們在這棟牆裡面與你隔閡。
We praise You for the gift of Your Son.
我感謝你因為耶穌基督。
That He came to tear down the wall that separated us from You.
祂來到我們這裡就是將這棟牆拆毀。
And we ask You, Father.
我們求問你神啊，我們請求你。
To break down the walls of sin that remain in our hearts.
將這棟有罪的牆嚟到拆毀，讓佢喺我哋心中拆毀佢。
We ask You to cause us to see them.
讓佢哋能夠可以睇到。
And cause us and give us grace to repent.
呼召我哋，俾我哋一個恩典嚟到回轉悔改。
And power to call upon the name of Jesus.
讓我哋有一個權力嚟到叫稱呼為耶穌基督。
And bring us back into the garden with You.
帶我哋翻返去嘅花園裏邊。
Let us rediscover the joy of fellowship and walking with God.
让我们再一次回到那种享受那种的喜乐。
Take our sinful and worldly desires away.
拿开我们自己的那个思念。
And fill us with Your desires.
但是充满你给我们的渴望。
So that each of us may be revived in walking in the way with You.
所以我们每一个人能够是同你一起同行。
And that together our church may be renewed and transformed.
让我们教会能够重新建立。
So that we're walking together with You.
让我们一起同行同心。
In joy.
喜乐。
To the glory of Your Son.
荣耀耶稣基督。
We pray these things in Jesus' name.
我们奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen. 将回应诗歌归家。
唱三一颂。
together for the benediction. And now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to make you stand in the presence of his glory, blameless and with great joy, to the only God our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory and majesty, dominion and authority, before all time, and now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
没有的话，我们就默祷后散。
默默地默祷散会。